If you read my book, Baseline Selling, I think it was Baseline Selling. It could have been Mindless Selling. But in one of those books, I talked about the early days of cold calling for me. Back in the early 70s, I had to spend all day knocking on doors to schedule my three meetings for that night. Had to have three meetings. So literally banging on people's doors in some crappy neighborhoods. People coming and answering their doors with guns. It's just miserable, scary. And to make it worse, my target prospect was an 18, 19, 20-year-old single girl. It didn't make it any easier that I'm asking people at every door I knocked on where the single girls lived. When I think back upon it, it sounds pretty creepy, especially in the environment that we're in lately with all the accusations and allegations. And while I don't have anything to worry about there, it was hard. And back in those days, I hated the door banging. I hated the cold calling. Even when I started this business, I hated the cold calling. Not because I was scared of it or uncomfortable with it. I hated what a waste of time it was. I hated that was the place where I could sometimes be ineffective compared to the rest of the sales process. So whether it was back in the early 70s or in my later business or when I started this business in the mid-80s, the goal was the same. I hate this enough, so I will dedicate myself to becoming so fucking good at this that it won't take long. That was the goal. How to get it from all day to book three meetings to a couple of hours. And 15 years later, how to get it from a couple of hours to 20 minutes. If I got somebody on the phone, I needed to be freaking awesome. This wasn't just a fire drill. This wasn't just some mental exercise. This wasn't busy work. I didn't see it as activity or behavior, and I didn't see it as a numbers game. And certainly you can focus on the numbers, where historically to generate this much business, you need this many new sales, and that's going to require this many first meetings, and that's going to require this many appointments, and that's going to require this many conversations, and that's going to require this many dials or attempts. I understand there are numbers, but my approach was to hell with the freaking numbers. I needed to be that good on every call, period. And I wasn't going to let up until I got that good on every call. If I talked to somebody on the phone, that just freaking had to convert to a meeting, period. If somebody answered their door, I either needed a meeting with them or I needed to know where there was somebody else on that street that I could knock on their door with an introduction or a referral and get a meeting scheduled. I hated the time I wasted making cold calls. I hated not getting a meeting. And nothing's changed today. I would find that completely unacceptable if I had a conversation with somebody and didn't convert that to a meeting. Fortunately, 19 out of 20 convert to meetings when I'm on the phone with somebody. So no problem. But I'm trying to help you guys. And part of it is mindset. It's not all mechanical and tactical. You've got the stuff you need to be tactically successful. Right now, I want you thinking about the mindset. You can't practice this enough. You can't role play this enough. And you can't be determined enough when it comes to making these calls. You're going to get objections. People are going to push back. People are going to revert to their automatic, it's a salesperson on the phone behavior, so I got to get rid of them. Even if you sound good, if they think that you might be selling something, they're going to act like a buyer and try to get rid of you. Nobody wants to talk to a salesperson. And that's why it's so important that you don't sound like one. That's why it's so important that you sound great, that you sound like someone they would choose to speak with. And I don't care what you have to do to get yourself to the point where you sound great. Chances are it means that you don't sound like you anymore. So what? You can sound like you later. You can sound like you at the dinner table with your girlfriend or boyfriend, your husband or your wife, with your kids or your parents. Be you later. On the phone, you got to be the best freaking salesperson who didn't sound like a salesperson ever. You need to be animated and passionate and warm and helpful and friendly and say the right words with the right pace, with the right energy. Sound like somebody that they want to talk to. And most of your problems will go away. I'm not saying you'll never get pushback, but God, will the pushback go subside? Okay, ask me questions.